Di Canio, oh, I do not believe that. That is sensational.
Now, should we get on to what is probably the most famous game, not in World Cup history, but certainly of the tournament? And it's always talked about, even to this day in Premier League football, it's always talked about because it's synonymous with referee decisions, VAR, and ultimately the shape of football as it is today. It is, of course, the round of 16 game between the plucky underdogs of South Korea, who are ranked 40th in the world, to who were three-time winners at the time, Italy, who are ranked sixth coming into the tournament. So, Harry, take us through what you remember of this game.
Yeah, so obviously, just to start, obviously, if it ends up being 2-1 to South Korea, again, in extra time, again, it's that golden goal. But obviously, that's just really the beginning of this story, because ever since then, we've had accusations of favoritism or match fixing or just poor refereeing. The Italians to this day will insist that it was stolen from them. I think even Sepp Blatter at one point condemned the officials. I don't think, personally, I hope not, maybe, but I don't think there's any sort of favouritism or match fixing here going on. I do think there were some poor decisions made in various games involving South Korea, but I don't think that there were anything nefarious. Mm. Obviously, in this game in particular, talking about the red card and whether that should have or shouldn't have been. I just find it a very, very weird subject, because obviously I don't know how much I remember of a time or how much it is I've been influenced of what I've seen since.
For sure, for sure. Yeah, I thought, let me tell you through what I kind of researched and kind of can put this image into the minds of our listeners to see if what they can remember and whether this adds up. So on paper, this straw was only going to go one way, and it was quickly backed up by an early goal from Christian Vieri. The referee, Byron Moreno, who was an Ecuadorian official, made several high-profile, what seems like biased decisions towards South Korea, including a penalty to Korea in the first half. But luckily, this was saved by masterful goalkeeper Gianluigi Buffon. And then Seol Ki-hyun equalised in the 88th minute, taking the game into extra time. But more referee decisions were made, as Byron Moreno disallowed would have been a golden goal for Italy for an apparent offside, but it wasn't offside at all. Christian Vieri was played onside by quite some distance. He would then send off Francesco Totti for diving, despite being 40 yards away from play. So how on earth would he know? Looking like it was heading to penalties, it would be An Jun-hwan, who had scored the golden goal in the 117th minute, progressing Korea to the quarterfinals for the first time. Back in Italy, there were riots in the streets. Allegedly, hitmen were contracted to hunt down the referee Byron Moreno, and he would retire from refereeing in 2003. Do you know what happened to him since?
I don't, actually.
In 2010, and this might make you mind up on whether he was a con man he might have been given a bung for refereeing. In 2010, he was caught smuggling heroin into JFK Airport in New York and spent 3 years in prison.
Crazy. Yeah.
So maybe there was something.
Maybe,
in it.
Yeah.
But he was a referee. He was a FIFA referee. Yeah. He was a referee before that. He refereed other games in the tournament.
I think it's so hard being a ref as well. Like, you also, you know, Italians accusing people of match fixing is, you know, pot and kettle, isn't it? But I feel like if we were talking about North Korea, if we were talking about you know, various other states around the world, then I might be more likely to believe it.
But I think it's one of the greatest conspiracies of all time, isn't it? It's up there with who shot JFK, and you know, was 9/11 an inside job? Area 51, South Korea, Italy, 2002. It's kind of, it all kind of fits in the small package. Where it falls down a little bit is that Italy, South Korea, Ecuadorian referee. If you were to draw a triangle between those three countries, you couldn't get further apart. No. However, you know, he does get caught smuggling heroin, so he's obviously prone to a bit of money making.
Is that because like he was forced to retire from refereeing and he needs to make money somehow? Who knows?
Yeah, it just feeds the enigma. there's got to be. I'd love to like there'd be like a comedy movie made on Byron Moreno. He's just. I can see him being played by like Will Ferrell. And he's a good man. He's just trying to do an honest day's work. He loves football. He gets injured as a kid. So he can't make it as a player, but he makes it as a referee. He makes it as the best referee in Ecuador. He gets shipped off to the World Cup. He's, you know, his family are really proud of him. I don't know. He has like an upset stomach in the morning of the game, and then it kind of clouds his judgment. And then, ends of him 10 years later, smuggling heroin through New York. That's the film I'd pay to watch. Don't think FIFA would give you the rights to use him. I swear I've had that referee on some of my FIFA 21 experiences. Some of the scripting going on there. Jesus. But it's probably important to say that this game kind of changed the shape of football in many ways. You know, it led to the elimination of the golden goal, first and foremost. Italy were outraged. You know, Italians still speak about this game to this day. Obviously, they would win it 4 years later, so some justice, I guess. So I suppose it kind of led to VAR in a weird kind of way, and kind of FIFA wanting to improve refereeing as such. Did you know this was Paolo Maldini's last game for Italy?
I didn't realise that, no.
His last game for Italy, and he has a FIFA World Cup record. He's played the most minutes of any player ever. He's played 2,217 minutes, and that is yet to be beaten.
Oh, amazing.
So if they didn't go into extra time, he wouldn't have got that record.
Well, he might. If they went through...
Yeah, thank you, Byron Moreno. Yeah.
I mean, if they went through, he would have, you know, the record would be longer, wouldn't it?
True. Oh, maybe. If he played.
Yeah.
Oh, Ollie, shut up. You don't know what you're talking about. Okay, fair enough. Right, let's move on quickly. Team.